Starting December 1, COVID-19 vaccinations will be made mandatory for all on-site workers who are eligible to get inoculated against the virus in areas with sufficient vaccine supplies. The country's anti-COVID task force approved the mandate as part of efforts to boost the country's vaccination numbers. But Malacañang was quick to clarify that non-vaccination against COVID-19 should not be a ground to terminate an employee.
Sa mga eligible employees na hindi bakunado, maaaring hindi sila matanggal sa trabaho dahil lamang sa rason na hindi sila bakunado. Pero kinakailangan nilang mag-undergo ng regular RT-PCR testing or antigen test at their own expense.
The IATF has also required the full vaccination of all eligible workers in public transportation services as a condition to continue their operations.
Isa pang measure ay hindi pagmarka ng absent sa lahat ng workers na mababakunahan sa oras ng trabaho basta magpakita lamang ng proof ng confirmed vaccination schedule.
The Labor Group Trade Union Congress of the Philippines supports the mandatory vaccination of on-site workers.
Looking forward to it. We are looking forward to a vaccination of a greater number of workers to help our economy recover immediately.
But the group says government should focus on boosting vaccine supply instead of punishing the unvaccinated.
Giving workers the incentives to vaccinate, to encourage them rather than to penalize or to coerce or scare them to vaccinate. No, we are also asking the government to provide more access for the workers because they are saying that the country has now sufficient number of vaccines. But when we look at the local government units, the workers, the people do not have the access to these vaccines.
Meanwhile, the IATF is enjoining government agencies and local government units to provide incentives for vaccination, such as giving priority to fully vaccinated individuals in accessing government services and programs. But Roque says this does not apply to frontline and emergency services, which shall continue to render assistance to all persons, regardless of vaccination status. For public and private establishments, they may require proof of vaccination from their customers or patrons and turn away individuals who remain unvaccinated even if they are eligible for vaccination. But for those who are not eligible to get vaccines, Roque says they can only present two documents to prove why they cannot get inoculated against COVID-19, a medical clearance or their birth certificate.